Thank you very much, Mr. President. I rise to speak on the resolution regarding the life and the legacy of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Let me first associate myself with the comments made by my colleagues here, particularly Senator Larkin. And thank you first, Colonel, for your service to this great country, but also to your service to the citizens of this great country. And I don't get tired of hearing you talk about your service, particularly though of that day. I also want to obviously thank Andrea Stewart Cousins, our leader and the sponsor of this resolution, and for her living the actual legacy of Dr. King, being the first woman to lead a legislative body here in the great state of New York, and being an African-American woman at that, and every day, the kind of grace and steady hand that she provides to our conference and to the Senate is certainly something that is worthy of Dr. King's legacy, and so we thank her for that. I am very, very happy to hear, just enjoy the comments that people are making today, and how everyone is really taking this time to internalize what Dr. King's legacy really is about, and I think that's really admirable, and I think that we're growing as a body, if not as people, in that conversation. But to kind of jump off and piggyback off of what Senator Bailey indicated is that we talk a lot about Dr. King's legacy, and particularly the March on Washington and about the I Have a Dream speech. But in that I Have a Dream speech, his main purpose, his main emphasis and theme was not about a dream. It really was about bringing a check to Washington, right? A check for justice, and a check that was marked insufficient funds by this country. And if we have that same check today, I think many of us would still find the Bank of Justice with insufficient funds here in America. And so there's lots to be done. Senator Klein indicated that as well. And there's lots that we can be doing. We don't have to go to Washington. We have our own Bank of Justice right here in Albany. And we really ought to be bringing that check to bear right here for each one of our constituencies and all over the state of New York. And we ought to make sure that we don't walk away from this session with this check still being marked insufficient funds. That we should make sure that on the issues of economic justice, that we are in fact are making sure that check is being cashed. We should make sure, again, on the issues of criminal justice reform, that we do the things that we know we could do this session to make sure that check for justice is in fact cashed. We should do raise the age. There's no reason not to. We should make sure that we codify the executive order that the governor put forward around the special prosecutor and make sure that we have a special prosecutor to deal with police, not just when an unarmed civilian is killed, but anytime a police officer has a problem and there's a contradiction conflict between the local DA and the police department. We need to really do some real work around marijuana decriminalization. We started that work. There's still lots to be done on it. We need to do that. I have a bill called the Safe Parole Act that would certainly make sure that people who deserve parole, especially, our prisons are filled with, non-violent felons who spent way more time than they should in our correctional facilities. And not only is it no longer an issue of public safety, but we're now throwing good money after bad, housing people in these prisons instead of allowing them to be back in their communities with their families. My colleague Senator Perkins has been sponsoring a bill to end solitary confinement. That certainly ought to be part of it. It really doesn't. And again, I'm all for the safety of the men and women who work very hard to secure these criminal justice facilities, but solitary confinement, we know, doesn't work and doesn't add to that safety of those folks. We need to stop jailing mentally ill people, right? Just simple and plain. And we've had about three people in the city of New York to this date. We're only at, this is only the 18th, right? 18 days into the year, we've already had three people in New York City who are mentally ill shot down by the police. We need to implement crisis intervention teams all over the state of New York and create a real modality to address the issues of people who have mental illness. We certainly also need to decrease the population at Rikers. And whether that's, you know, speeding up trials or not, you know, or having a sensible bail policy, we certainly need to do it. These are the kinds of policy things that we can do right here this year to, in fact, live through Dr. King's legacy. We want to talk about, you know, being king-like and using Dr. King as an exemplar. Here's just a few things that we could do that certainly, and this is just on one issue, that would really make a difference in the lives of our constituencies and make us a better place. We need to remember the important thing that Dr. King left us with, that peace is not simply the absence of war, but the presence of justice. Thank you very much, Mr. President.